Hello all, this is the video about demonstration of accessing the websites which are essential for a researcher in medicine. So first and foremost, we start with the PubMed library. That is the official US National Library of Medicine from National Institutes of Health. So where you can type the mesh terms, the medical subject headings. So where if you type here and click on the search here, you will find out the articles. If you click on the link here, you can directly access these articles. If free texts are available, then you can download it and you can use it. And you can further refine your search by the means of article types, text availability. That is, if you want to access only the articles where free full text is available, you can click on this. And the recent ones, past 5 years, 10 years, and you can custom range and you can identify articles based on that. Then you can add additional filters like this. Suppose you want to study heart disease only in females, then you can select this sex and you can click on male for it. If you click on here, then male females will appear. Then only the studies which is done within females will be displayed here. So you can create additional filters based on the age, search fields, journal categories, subjects, etc. You can refine your search and you can refine your review of literature. So basically all these articles you can quote in review of literature. The beautiful thing about PubMed is you can sign in, and if you go to INCBA, then you can see your previous searches, what and all you have accessed, that you can check. Then you can have a my bibliography and all. So that is out of context now. So if we are clicking on a single article here, then the abstract will appear here. If there is a free article available, the links will be available. It may be either free full text or a paid version link will be available. The best thing about PubMed is the similar articles will be there. So you can, if your interest is, if your study is about heart disease in pregnancy, then these topics will best fit into the review of literature for those articles. So you have to look in here. So that is about the PubMed. Then we are moving into this PubMed, which is a newer version which is available. So this is new PubMed. So the same thing with the newly available, the same thing, the text availability, article type, publication date and additional filters were available. So we can add all the filters, numbers have increased, article type, species, language, you can filter, gender we can filter, subject, journal, age, everything we can filter. So, and we can refine our literature. So that way now PubMed is working on all these things. So we can sort again by best match or by the most recent one. Now this is one thing which is most important in this literature search is about the boolean terms. So that is when we are typing, I have already typed this heart disease here. So suppose if I want to study only heart disease and within pregnancy, then I need to type heart disease and pregnancy. So heart disease and pregnancy will be there. If I give a search here, then the number of articles will appear like this. For this search, we need to click on here advanced search. Heart disease and pregnancy. So again, if I want heart disease, so I have to add here. So I want to exclude pregnancy from here. Then I need to add pregnancy and click on here and I have to say not pregnancy. So I need to click. So the number of articles will appear, which the articles will be within heart disease and also in pregnancy. Suppose if I want studies which is from heart disease and studies from pregnancy, then I need to in the advanced search I need to add R. So the same way I need to type hard disk. Hard disk. I need to type R and pregnancy. So hard disk are pregnancy. So when I search here, the number will be increased definitely, because it will show the studies, the list of studies which has hard disk and pregnancies separately. So this is about the Boolean logics. This Boolean logics is useful for Google Scholar also. So this is about how the basic things about the usage of the PubMed and the filtering the article, refining our review of literature. Now the next important tool which we are going to see about is the Google. We should not forget about in research work, we should not forget about the contribution of Google and YouTube, where many of the demonstrations are available in YouTube, and the search engine Google serves an enormous thing. So when we type heart disease and pregnancy like this, so there will be articles. So it will, there will be some websites, common websites and forums where you can get a data. These things will be useful especially when you are writing introduction. So we should not neglect the contribution of Google search for the research, but the only thing is we need to check the authentic sites, whether those sites are standard sites giving the information. So then from Google we are moving on to the Google Scholar, which is again this same Google Scholars, the similar to PubMed search engine. We have Google Scholar search engine. If you type the number of heart disease and pregnancy here, the articles will appear like this. The best thing about Google Scholar is it has a profile which we will see later. So before that, if the articles will appear here, we can click on this and open this, and we can access the article, and all the freely available articles will be shown in the right side, this side. So we can access this article directly, the free access. The best thing about is we can save this article for future use. And the other thing is here, if we click on the cite, this is the cite button, then the way you have to cite will appear here. If in case if you are not using any reference manager or referent softwares for reference management, then this is easy. So if you want to type, copy this manpower, just click on this, copy this, then you paste it in your document. The citation will be easy for you. Then you can look at the related articles, where you can click on this related articles. Then this will be the same way in PubMed how we showed here the same similar articles which will help in the review of literature. Same way here the similar review of literature will appear. So that's how we have opened this article. So the same, it has opened to the same particular page that article has been opened. So now the third important thing is the topmost secret of this presentation is the Sci-hub. So suppose you want to see some, this is not freely available. So you click on this, and you just copy this link and paste here. See, basically Sci-hub is the Robin Hood of this research field. So if you click here, it will appear. So it will ask for the captcha. So if we type and enter here, basically it's a Russian site, so the language will be different. So the article will be retrieved. So same way, many of these articles which are paid, which you can't afford, can be accessed through the site, and you can, it is freely available for download also. So you can download these articles. So in that way, Sci-hub is a, so it will show how where to save and all. So we can save it later. So same way, we can download the articles which are paid. Almost 99% of the times this Sci-hub will be working. So we need to remember, we suppose this is blocked in the particular country. TW is the domain which is used in India. So in, it differs from country to country, and it will be frequently changing also based on If suppose a country bans it, then it will be changed. So you can either type the URL, you can type the PubMed ID or digital operator identifier number. So that's how you can open this thing. So this site is run by they accept donations, and these donations are spent for the legal battle against these publishers. So now the next important site which we are going to see about is the Equator-Network.org. This that is enhancing the quality and transparency of the health research site, which will be useful for the reporting guidelines. This site will give you all standard reporting guidelines specific to the type of the study design. That is, for randomized controlled trial, we all know consort guidelines is an important thing, and for randomized controlled trial, what are all other extensions, that is other documents which will help you in enhancing the quality, will be given here. Observational studies, stroke guidelines, systematic review, PRISMA guidelines, this will be readily available to download. As of now, this Equator-Network.org is giving us reporting guidelines. This peer reviewing research and other articles are under construction, so they are building on it. So suppose we see here this randomized controlled trial extension, so for reporting NF1 trials of traditional Chinese medicine, like that, so many materials related to randomized control will be available. If you look at this home page, we can see this standard reporting guidelines. This will give you a checklist based approach for writing methodology and for writing your paper, entire article. So this will be one very useful site. Then we are moving on to the jainbiosemantics.org, which will help you in identifying the journal for publishing. So if you want to look at heart disease and pregnancy, type heart disease and pregnancy, then you click on the find journals, then automatically the journals which can take up these kind of articles will be published. Usually in Jain Biosemantics, we have to type either the title or the abstract. So it will tell you which journal will suit you the best. So whether what is the indexing of that journal, and what is that article influence, and what are all the articles in that particular journal can be displayed. And from all the journals which is available here, you can select anyone. The problem with this list is these are all highly standard journals, where the publications charges will be high, acceptance rate will be very less. So that will be the problem. So from here we are moving on to the next important website, the Grammarly. Take our article, we can either paste here, copy and paste here, and we can check the spelling and also the grammar based on the week's correctness, clarity and engagement and delivery. All these aspects will be looked up in the document, and the pro will give you many extra features. Grammarly will offer extra plagiarism checker also. So if you are uploading a document, you can check for plagiarism also. And if you have this Grammarly plugin in the browser, then automatically when you type in the browser, it will correct you. You can have this Grammarly plugin in MS Word also. Now from this will immensely help you in making the article. Then we are moving on to the next important site, is that researchgate.net. These are all the next three groups will be social networking. So that is, after publishing our paper, we have to collaborate with the researchers and see what our related researchers are doing and what related researchers are going on. That has to be related to ourselves. So this ResearchGate does this function. So basically ResearchGate, if you create an account through your institutional email ID, if not, if you are already published, through link you can join. Out of this LinkedIn, anybody can join with a valid email ID. ResearchGate will ask for it, but if you have already publication, then it will accept. But you have to write to ResearchGate and create an account. So from there you can identify your profile, your co-authors, their publications, their related research, all these things we can do with ResearchGate. So the next important social networking can be done with Google Scholar also through that my profile and links. So in LinkedIn offers this social networking, not only sharing the content but also messaging services but job services, and LinkedIn Learning is there where we can learn, improve our skills. Then Mendeley also offers this social networking for the research. So we have to create an email ID for our create a profile for us in this website, and we also have this citation updates. The best thing about this social networking site is it will increase our articles visibility to others, and that will further finally land up in increased citations, and that will increase the author's H index and I index. So the quality of the paper is going to get decided with the citations. So all these social networking sites will help us in improving our citations. So these are all the basic essential websites which everybody should know. That is starting from the PubMed. PubMed had a new version, newer version. Then Google, YouTube for other demos. Then we Sci-hub. Then we had Equator Network. Then we had seen this for the selection of the journal, chainbiosemantics.org. Then Grammarly for manuscript writing services, social networking, apart from your Google Scholar, ResearchGate, LinkedIn, Mendeley will be useful. So when you use websites day to day in your research will be enhanced. Hopefully this presentation was useful to you. In next video, we will show what are all the essential softwares for research. Till then, subscribe to the channel, click on the bell icon. Thank you.